I don't want to get 3 years down the line and go, actually,
everybody,
I don't work anymore.
Can I ask you, this is more of, have you met Tim Burton? Okay, this is obviously, I don't know, you might have like hid behind the computer.
No, the first time I met him, he sat in on my editorial. So obviously, I was absolutely drenched with sweat. And he was like, hi, I'm Tim. I was like, yeah, right. But he was really, really nice. And you can see why he is.
He's so disappointed.
He's like a whirlwind. Like, he came around the studio very quickly. And, you know, he always had about four or five people around him, and he was just firing it, whether he was on a bit of the marching powder or not. He was just like, and he was really good. He'd come to the auditorium with the animators, and he would show us what his editor, because we had our editor, and then Tim always has Chris Levinson, who's done all his movies. And basically, he wanted to treat it like a live-action film, and so he sped it up and slowed it down. So he's quite into sort of tweak, which, you know, pissed some of the animators off, because obviously he's spending this time and he's like speeding it up and slowing it down. He did it with that MoMA thing, the robot. I had to do it sort of pumping up this pump, and he sort of tweaked it up. And I was like, it looks like he's just doing that. Yeah. But that's what Tim wanted. So you can see why he is who he is, because he is very focused. My partner Michelle, she does a lot of the costumes, so she spends quite a bit of time with him. And he does these really crude drawings, but he knows exactly what he wants. Whereas Wes had to be, you know, edged on. He had to feed him more.
In a Paris hotel room.
He had a big budget, but didn't really know what he wanted. That's what I want. He did actually know what he wanted in a lot of different areas, but the animation side wasn't so primary in his focus, whereas Henry or Tim Burton, they're very, you know, visual animation-y type people.